We have a religion in that there is scripture and there are questions you're not supposed to ask and there is original sin. And so, for example, there is scripture. The scripture says that America is based on racism and that racism is what America is all about today. Now, those aren't indefensible positions, but we're taught now to treat those things as scripture. And so, for example, if someone like Ta-Nehisi Coates at The Atlantic writes a piece called A Case for Reparations, and the main point is to indicate that scripture that I said, then the piece isn't engaged. At this point, what people like about a piece like that, who are members of this anti-racism religion, is simply that it was said and they're hearkening to the proclamation. So the idea that you're supposed to engage or ask questions, or some people might even want to be skeptical, that's considered incorrect. It's considered heretical. Now, this is not a knock on Ta-Nehisi Coates and what he wrote.
Right.
It's the way the work is supposed to be received, and that also goes for his current book.
And I didn't think it was. I thought that you, the way you did it was just as a starting point, because it
Very
was.
Much.
You said it, when this book came out, and many people had written things about reparations before.
Very much.
It wasn't that different than what many people had written, but this mm-hmm. was seen as gospel.
Yeah, I was genuinely perplexed, because I just thought, reparations less than 15 years ago, we kind of already went through this, and yet there was this reception. And also, we all know that reparations isn't going to happen in any real way, and yet there was this reception. And that's when I realized, wait a minute, it's that he's preaching, and there is a community of people who are taking in the preaching. And why I call it preaching is because there's a sense in this religion that if you ask questions beyond a certain small point, then there's something wrong with you. There are things that you're supposed to just allow. And so, for example, apart from what Ta-Nehisi Coates has written, suppose somebody asks, and I'm noticing that people are asking this a lot lately, why is it that the black community is much more upset about one white cop killing a black man or a black woman than the black men who, for various reasons, are killing one another at alarming rates in our cities year after year? Why is it that people are more upset? Now, if you ask that question, then you're given half answers. Somebody will say that there's a difference between people doing it from within the community as opposed to doing it as a figure of authority. But
what's the difference?
That's not a satisfying answer. You might have more questions, but you're not supposed to ask. Or somebody will, like Charles Blow, for example, will say that the people who are killing each other in these communities are doing it within a structure of racism. Now, that's a start, but you might want to say, still, why are we more upset at the one white cop? You're not to ask. Now, of course, there are people who do ask, but when you ask the question, you're treated as if you've done something wrong. You've blown on a tuba in church. You're racist. You don't get it. You're not understanding the scripture. You're not with Jesus. That's what it is.
You say that it's not unlike religion. It's you must have faith. It's like someone saying in an argument when you're talking about politics or whatever, you say, well, why is that? Because God said, or because the Bible said. There are just certain things that you just don't go, and you have to buy into that.
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise,
you are wrong.
There
are certain questions you are simply not to ask. Or, if you ask them, you are treated as if you've done something wrong. The eyes roll. You are part of the problem. You are evidence that America doesn't want to talk about race and racism, when I think you and I both know that we mm-hmm. talk about it all
A
the
lot.
Time.
Yeah.
The idea that anybody would say that is what I mean by religion.